The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, third chapter, text number 7, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on January 1st, 1976, in Madras, India.
We are preaching Krishna consciousness all over the world, and we are getting good response because we are preaching Bhagavad Gita heavy. This book is here in this Bhagavad Gita heavy. We do not make any false interpretation so that reader also spoils and the listener is also. There are so many people, sometimes they come forward to give me some credit that I have done very wonderful things. I reply that I do not know I have to do something wonderful. I cannot manufacture gold. I cannot show any jewelry. But if there is any credit, that the only credit is I don't adulterate. The pure milk, I don't show my expert service by adding water. That I do. So we present Bhagavad Gita as in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is the supreme law. All the Vedic literature, Krishna is accepted as the supreme law, person, the supreme personality of God. Ishvara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha, Anadi Adi Govinda Sarvakaranta. And the Vedanta Sutra, it is inquired, Adhata Brahma Jigyasa, what is Brahma? This human life is meant for understanding Brahma. Aham Brahmasmi. This is real education. So, that part of Brahma, we are Brahma, but Krishna is part of Brahma. Nitya Nityana Chetana Chetana. He is the supreme Nitya, eternal. Krishna is also eternal, we are also eternal. Nahanape Hannamane Sarile. So, Nitya Nityana Chetana Chetana. And what is the difference between Krishna and me? The difference is ego to bahunam vidyadhitam. Krishna maintains all this buddhism. He is similar. Nitya, nityana. He is similar. That this similar number and pura number, what is the difference? Difference is that Krishna is the maintainer and we are the maintained. Krishna is the predominator, we are predominated. This is so our preaching is this Krishna consciousness that people are searching after God, speculating throughout the whole life. But here Krishna is, can imagine, here I am. No. Avajanti manmurha. God is canvassing, here I am. And these people are searching at all. Let's see. Why? That is explained here. Ahamkara vimula, ma. False egoism. Ahamkara, katta aham iti manmati. He is fully under the control of prakriti, and still he is thinking independent. That is vimula, vivida. Prakita kirmanani gunai karmani sarvasa ahankara vimulatma karta aham iti mandala. The material world, especially in this age, everyone is thinking, oh, I am the greatest. Who can become more than me? Ahankara vimulatma. This material world is like that. Everyone is thinking like that. Or asurik pravritti, who adhars me, mama sama, he is greater than me. There is a struggle for this vimulatma competition. But at the end, he is under the control of nature. Everyone knows it. Because ultimately the death will come and all ahankara will be separated. I don't care for God, I independent, I am God. All these ahankara, false egoism, on account of bewildered, being bewildered, these things will be finished. When Krishna will come as death, everything will be finished. Mrittu sarva harasyam. Krishna has described himself that I am death and I take away all your possessions. That's all. As death. It will be taken away. However intelligent we may be, I am proud we may be for our position, but the death is sure as death. And when death comes, the death is also another form of Krishna. He will take everything, just like Hiranyakashipu. He was very, very proud of his position. He was controlling over the three worlds. He was chastising his own son, Prahlad Maharaj. In this way he was very, very proud. But when Krishna came as Nrisimhadev, everything was finished within a second. So we should not mistake this fact. Krishna therefore presents that your real problem is birth, death, old age and disease. Your real problem. You are making solution of all the problems by scientific advancement, by education, by so on, political maneuvers, that is all right. But how you are going to solve this problem? How you solve this problem? Actually, human life is meant for solving this problem, not this temporary problem. Temporary problem in war. If you don't solve this problem, janma mrityu jara vyadhi, then any form of life, there will be problems. Even if you are elevated to the heavenly planets, there are also problems. Indra is not very happy there, the king of heavenly planets. Although the higher planets, the duration of life, the standard of civilization, standard of comfort, many, many thousand times greater than here. But the same problem, janma mrityu jara vyadhi, is there. We cannot avoid. But actually our problem is that nobody wants to die. That's a fact. But this is enforced. No young man wants to become old man. But it is enforced. You cannot avoid. We should understand, this is sense, that we are not independent. That's a fact. Prakita kiramanani. And above prakriti, there is Krishna. Mayadhakshena prakriti, syati sacharataram. hetulanina kaunteya jagandi parivartate. So, therefore, Krishna is accepted as the supreme controller. Ishara Parama Krishna. Ishara means controller, one who controls. Everyone has got some capacity to control everyone of us. You are also controlling your family, controlling your business. I am controlling this institution and so on. So everyone has got some. In that sense, everyone is Ishara. There is no fight on this point. But we are controllers of a limited circle, but we are controllers. That is our position. Not that I am simply controller, but I am controlled by higher authority. So therefore, I am not supreme controller. I am controller, Ishara. But here is one Ishara, Krishna. Ishara Parama. He is supreme controller. Why supreme controller? Because he is not controlled by anyone. That is Krishna's position. Krishna, when he was present on this planet, he practically demonstrated that he controlled everyone, but nobody controlled him. That is called Paramesha. Ishara everyone, maybe. God everyone, maybe. But Godhead is Krishna. Nitya, Nityanam, Chaitanam, Chaitanam. So we should understand it very nicely, and it is not very difficult. The same controller is coming before us as one of us, as human beings. But we are not accepting it. That is the difficult. Abhijananti manamura manasim tanuvan. That is very regretful. Krishna says that I am coming to exhibit who is the supreme controller, and I am playing as human being so that everyone can understand. I am giving instruction in the Bhagavad Gita. Still, these fools, the rascals, they cannot understand. So, God is there. We can give the God's name, Krishna. God's address on Vrindavan. God's father's name, mother's name. So why is it difficult to find out God? But they will not accept. They will not accept. Mura, they have been described as Mura. So this morning, this place before us, asking me, what is the purpose of your moments? I said, to educate the Mura. That's all. This is the common substance of this Krishna consciousness moment, that you are trying to educate the Mura. And who is Mura? That is described by Krishna. Namara Vishkiti na Mura Pravardhanti Narasama. Why? Maya Puritagyana. Why Maya has taken on his knowledge? Asuri Bhava Mahasiva. So we have got very simple test. Test like a chemist in the small test tube can analyze what is the liquid. So, we are not very intelligent. We are also one of so many Muras. But we have got the taste. Krishna says, we like to remain Mura and take education from Krishna, which is Krishna consciousness. We do not pose ourselves as very learned scholar and very eager scholar. We know everything. No. We are Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He also tried to remain a Mura. When he talked with Prakashananda Saraswati, you are Maharaja Sannyasi. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was dancing and chanting. So this Maharaja Sannyasi was criticizing him that he is a Sannyasi and he is simply chanting and dancing with some sentimental persons. What is this? So a meeting was arranged and between Prakashananda Saraswati and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In that meeting, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu attended as a humble sannyasi. So Prakashananda Saraswati questioned him, "Sir, you are a sannyasi, your duty is to study Vedanta always. Now how is that you are chanting and dancing? You are not reading Vedanta?" Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, "Yes, sir, that's a fact. You know, I am doing because my Guru Maharaj saw me in Mura yesterday." How is that? He said, "Guru Mari Murkha Dekhi Korila Sasam." My Guru Maharaj saw me a fool number one and he chastised me. How he has chastised you? He had no jurisdiction for studying Vedanta. It is not possible for you. You are a Mura. You better chant. So what is this purpose? The purpose is, at the present moment, these Muras, how they will understand Vedanta? Better chant Hare Krishna. Then you will get all knowledge. Hare Nama, Hare Nama. Hare Nama Iva Kevalam, Kalo Nasti Iva Nasti Iva Nasti Iva Svadhirana. In these days, people are so fallen. You know what they will understand Vedanta and who has got the time to read Vedanta. So, better take the education of Vedanta directly. As Krishna says, Vedaishya Sarvai Aham Iva Vrittam. So, Vedanta knowledge is our sabdhyadana vritti. By chanting the sabda brahma, one can be liberated. So this is recommended in the shastras. Harinnama, 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 iva kevalam, kalom nasti, iva nasti, iva nasti, iva gatirannata. So if one is actually interested how to become liberated from this material bondage, janma mitra jaya vyadhi, these are the problems, then according to Shastra, according to Mahayana, one must take to this chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. This is our, purpose. So, even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you are so learned scholar, every one of you know, and you are very popular leader at Navadvip. And when he was 16 years old only, he defeated one very great learned scholar, Keshav Kashmiri. And he was known as Nimai Pandit. Actually, he was a very learned scholar, and the explanation of one verse, Akparamashtamanayo Nidgankhya Apiyari Gurukrame, he described this verse in 64 ways. He was such a learned scholar. So he was not a fool, but he represented the fool of this age, that if you want liberation from material bondage, because this human form of life is meant for that purpose. Janma mitra jara vyadhi dukkha dosharu. This human life is meant for getting out of this encasement of repetition of birth, death, old age and disease. This is human form of life. It is meant for. Unfortunately, there is no education that why I do not want death, but why death is compulsory, I do not want old age, why old age is compulsory, I do not want to take birth, why birth is compulsory. These are the actual questions problems of life, and our whole Vedic literature is meant for solving this problem. That is the whole purpose. Vedic literature, Vedic civilization is not meant for working day and night like animals, only for maintaining the foodstuff and sense gratification. It is not civilization. According to our Vedic civilization, this is not civilization. This is another form of animal life. Because Rishabde says, Nayam deha deho majamani loke kastan kaman arahati ujamani tapo dibvam putrakajina suddhita satya. That is it. Suddhita satya, satya, our existence is now polluted, infect. Therefore, we have to accept what this old identity is. That cats and dogs, they cannot get this opportunity. How to purify the existence, how to become free from this whole principles of material unhappiness. They cannot understand, they cannot study Vedic literature, they cannot take instruction on Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam. So if we do not take advantage of our Vedic knowledge which is found in India, then we are spoiling our life. Therefore Narottama Das Thakur has sung a very nice song. Hari Hari Vipale Janama Boy. My Lord, Hari Krishna, I have simply wasted my time. Why? Manusya Janama Paiya Radha Krishna Nam Bhajiya Janiya Suniya Vishakhaya. I got this human form of life, but I did not take the advantage offered in this life to understand Krishna. Therefore, I have taken poison going in. So this Krishna consciousness movement is very important. It is not something manufactured mental compulsion. It is authorized movement. Krishna says, sarva dharmān paritrajya māmekam śaraṇam vraja matta paradaram nānya kincidasti dhananjaya. There is no more superior fact than Krishna. That you have to understand. And how he is superior. We are taking nature as very wonderful, but behind the nature, the manipulator, the control, is Krishna. That you have to understand. That is understanding of Krishna. The big scientists are finding out the wonderful natural laws, but it is their duty to find out who has made this law and how it is being conducted so nicely. That answer is there. Prakriti maya dhakshena prakriti suyate sachara asaram hetunani na kauntya yada vi parivartate. The prakriti is very powerful, there is no doubt. In the Brahma Sangita also it is stated that sthisthisthiti palaya sadhana shaktirika chayiva jasya bhavanani vibhakti durga. Durga, God is Durga. She is the prakriti power and she can create, she can maintain, she can annihilate. Sthisthisthiti palaya sadhana shaktirika chayiva jasya bhavanani vibhakti. But she is acting just like shadow, not independent. Ichchānu rupavapi jasacha cesta tesa govinda māri. Come on. The Govinda is the ultimate background, sarva-kāra-vatāra. Ishana paramatthika. This is the Brahma Sangita written by Lord Brahma. And he is personally explaining himself. What is this difficult? bhakti, to understand Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So we should take opportunity of this human form of life, how to understand. If one has got this human form of life, it is difficult. Where Krishna says, manushanam sahasresu, kaschid jata visiddhaya, jata tam visiddhaya, kaschid vrittimam tapra. So there are so many things to be learned about Krishna. Krishna says that I am controlling the material nature. Now, if you are actually very great scientist, you find out how Krishna is controlling. Very easy. Idam nipunsas tapasa sutasava. Actually, education, tapasa means that you should understand what is the ultimate truth, how is acting. Then your education, your scientific knowledge is perfect. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said in the Naimisharam, na? Atapvambhi vijasresha varnasama vibhagas sanusthitasya dharmasya sanusiddhi aritosa. So whatever you do, it doesn't matter, but try to satisfy the Supreme Law by your work. That is the perfection of life. Sanksiddhi paripoksa. You cannot. This is foolishness. Now there is no God. How you can say so? You are completely under the control of the laws of nature. And nature is being controlled by God. How you can say that you are independent of Therefore, it is not very good business that people are pushing on a type of civilization, godless civilization. They will never be happy because we are so controlled that after that we have to accept tathade hantara prati. You cannot stop that. As you cannot stop, that's a boy. If he says, no, I will not grow. Father says, my dear boy, you are playing all day. Go to school, learn something, other in future you will be unhappy, you will not be able to maintain yourself. If the boy says, no, I am no future. I will not become a young man. I shall play. And that is not a fact. You have to become a young man. And you have to take responsibility. So similarly, Krishna says, Dehi nasmin yatha dehi kaumana yogana jara tatha dehantara prapti dhirasatanamayi. So dehantara prapti is there. That's a fact. How you can say I am independent? It is foolishness. You are not independent. How dehantara prapti? Karvana daiva netrena according to your karma. In this life, we are preparing ourselves for the next life. How it is? Jāti dīva prātādevān pidrīnyānti pidrītvatā dūte jādānti madhyādi nōki jānti māṁ. You have to prepare yourself. So, leaving aside the black side, you take the bright side, that you are trying to go to the higher planetary system, Sarvalok, Janalok, Mahalok, Tapalok. So you have to prepare yourself. Trying to go to the moon planet. But according to our calculation, they have never gone to the moon planet. They have never gone. Because we find in the Shastra, the moon planet is situated 1,600,000 miles above the sun. They calculate the 93 million of miles the sun is situated. The 93 million plus another 1,600,000 becomes 95 million miles. How one can go 95 million of miles in 4 days? So according to our sattva, we cannot believe this statement. So apart from this discussion, you can go to the moon planet. That is also one of the heavenly planets. But you have to prepare for this. That is karma kanda. You have to perform certain such yajnas. It is not that by force you can go any other planet. By force you cannot go even any other parts of the world here. If you want to go to America, you have to take passport, visa, and so many things. And you will be allowed to go to the moon planet without any visa and passport. How is it possible? It is common. They are so poor that some rascal will take some machine and go there. That is not possible. So, we have to prepare. So Krishna says, Jāti deva bhṛtā deva. If you want to go to the heavenly planet, you can go. You prepare yourself. Pitri jnāti, pitri loka, you can go. Marjā deva bhṛtāti mama. But, if you prepare yourself for coming to me, back to home, back, you can do it. So, if we have to prepare ourselves to go to our higher planetary system, and here within this material world, within this universe, abrahma bhavana lokana punaravartino, even if you go to the highest planetary system, brahma loka, the brahma loka means you cannot calculate one day's life. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Sahasra yuga varjantam arahajyat brahmanohmi. Sahasra yuga, one yuga means 43 lakhs of years. And multiplied by 1,000. Such year is only 12 hours of brahma loka. Similarly, 24 hours, one more, 1 year. It is very, very long duration of life there, where Brahma lives. But still, you have to die. Abharma bhuna lokan punuravartina. So, madhyam gatya punarjanmana vidyate. These are instructions are there, and we are trying to educate people and Krishna consciousness. But if we think foolishly that I am independent, you can do that. But we are not independent, that's a fact. Prakriti Kriyamanani, we are fully under the control of Prakriti, and we have to change types of body. There are 8,400,000 different types of bodies. Jalajano, Lakhani, Thavala, Lakhavinsati, they are all stated. And this human form of life is very, very, very rarely we have obtained. Therefore, Prahlāda Maharaj said that durlabhama manasama janma. This human form of life is very, very difficult to obtain. Samarada, we have now this human form of life. Krishna says that utilize it very nicely so that the problems of life and that knowledge is very easy. Krishna says, janma karma so means divam, jo janati kavya. Simply try to understand Krishna. That is all. And Krishna is explaining himself what he is. Where is the difficulty? Unless you make some interpretation fully, everything is very, very clear. So you can understand Krishna. And if you understand Krishna, then the result is janma karma samhi dibbam tu janati sattata takta deham punar janma naiti mami. Very difficult. There is no difficulty. Therefore our request is get to this Krishna consciousness. If the foreigners can take to it very seriously, so why not Indians? It is Indian knowledge. Bhagavad Gita was spoken in India. Why you are neglecting it? Why not taking advantage? Why you are falsely proud that you are independent? These are our questions. You are not independent. You are under the full control of Prakriti. So you have to rectify. Tapodipam jina suddev satya jasmat brahma sukham manantam. That is that we want happiness. But here, any happiness, there is no happiness, it is simply distress. But even if we take that happiness, that is temporary. But we want unlimited, unending happiness. So that you can have if you perform tapasya. Tapasya brahmacarsina samena samena. That is life. Human life is meant for tapasya. Little tapasya. Little tapasya, not very difficult. We are asking this boy, dear of me and others, that you simply give us these four principles of sinful life. Because if you remain sinful, you cannot understand God. That is not. Therefore Krishna is saying, Mama, Nama, Dushkriti, Nama. One who has engaged in sinful activities, they cannot. That is not possible. Jesam antagatam pāpam jananam punna karma te dandamaha nirmukta bhajanti ma. We have to be free from sinful life. And now, it is practical. Now, we are, according to Shastra, we are prescribed. No illicit sex, no meat eating, no gambling, no intercourse. Four no. Then you become free from sinful life. And then chant Hare Krishna, your life is free. It is not very difficult. Provided we are serious to take it. So that is our request. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama. Even if you cannot give up the four principles of sinful life immediately, but you take to Krishna consciousness, chant Hare Krishna mantra, then it gradually gets strength, just like this European American boy. From their childhood, they are trained now for this sinful life. But they have given up. Complete. Young man is still there. So, the method is very simple. Cheta dharpana mājanam, bhava mahādāvāgni nitvāpanam. If we chant Hare Krishna mantra, then the mirror of the core of heart will be clean. Cheta dharpana mājanam. And then bhava mahādāvāgni nitvāpanam. This repetition of what they told in a disease. This is just like a fire in the forest. Nobody wants it. But it is forced upon us. That's why nobody wants go to set fire in the forest. But it gets there. Naturally. Similarly, if you remain in this material world, then you have to be, and to say, put into the stimulations of materialistic way of life. There is no escape. Saṃsāra dāvānala. It is just like dāvāna. So, cetadarpana mājanam bhava mahādāvāna. As soon as you understand that I do not belong to this material world, brahma bhūta prasannātmā nasurocitīyama, then all problems of life is solved. This is cetadarpana mājanam. As soon as one is clean of the dirty things in the heart, then he can understand that I am part and parcel of Krishna. My duty is to serve Krishna. So let me be engaged in his service and become successful in his human form. Thank you very much.
It is Krishnaism. What is this sound?
Hinduism means a type of faith, or Muslimism is type of faith. But as it is described in the English dictionary, religion means a kind of faith. It is not that type of religion. It is a compulsory fact. Just like sugar is compulsorily must become sweet. If sugar is not sweet, that is not real sugar. Chili is not hot, that is not real chili. Similarly, we are part and parcel of Krishna, Our duty is to become Krishna conscious. There is no question of faith. It is not a question of faith. You may have faith in Hinduism, tomorrow you may have faith in Krishna, or you may have faith in Krishna and tomorrow in Mahavira. This kind of faith is not Krishna conscious. It is compulsory. Compulsory, it's like laws of the state. It is not that it is meant for the Hindus or for the Muslims, for the Christians. It is meant for everyone. Similarly, Mamaivamsa Jiva Bhuta, we are part and parcel of Krishna. So, it is compulsory to revive our consciousness that we are part and parcel of Krishna. It is not a question of faith. Faith you may accept or do not accept, but here it is a question of must. You must revive your Krishna consciousness, otherwise you will suffer.
The personal form and impersonal form, there are two conceptions. And Krishna explains this, that maya tadamidam satvam jagatam bhaktam uttina abhaktam, impersonal. That is another form of Krishna. He says maya, by me, I am all pervading. Maya tadamidam sadvam. That is sadvam kalidam brahma. Because he is expanded everywhere. That is impersonal. But as maya, he says, by me, then he is what? So, the whole creation is Krishna's expansion of energy. Just like the sunshine. Sunshine is also the same quality, heat and light, as the sun glow or the sun god. But the sunshine is impersonal. And the sun glow is localized. And within the sun glow, there is sun god. So that is the main of everything. Ishvara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vidya. Brahmanaham Pratishtha. The Brahma Jyoti is also staying in Krishna. Krishna is the source of Brahma Jyoti. So, impersonal or personal, whatever you take, that is Brahma. Brahma iti, Paramatma iti, Bhagavan iti, sab. But the beginning, origin, is Krishna. That Krishna explains, Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam pravartate. Either you take impersonal Brahma or localized Paramatma, whatever you take, that is emanation from Krishna. Sarvakaranaka. So, of course, if you worship impersonal form, Brahma, Jyoti, that is also Krishna. But Krishna says, Klesha avigatarastesham of bhaktya sattva-siddhasam. If you want to approach the absolute truth to the impersonal form, then it will be little difficult. Perhaps you may not reach the ultimate goal. You may fall down. There are so many instances we have seen in India, so many big sannyasi. They give up the sword, Brahma Sastra Jagan Mithya. But after some days, they come down to this jagat and engage themselves in political. Why? They could not stay in the Brahma state. That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Janneira Vinyakha Vimukha Vāryu. By concentrating on the impersonal form, they think that they have become liberated. But actually, that is not. Amishuddha Buddhaya. The impersonal conception is not purified intelligence. Then nirvindakha vimukta mani. You may think that I have become liberated, but it is not. Why? Arujya kritthena param padam tataha padam diyadha. After so much trouble and austerity, penances, you may acquire the position in the impersonal Brahma, but there is chance of falling down from there. Patanti adha. Why? Anadita jismatam ghaya. Because they could not find out how to worship your lotus feet. So, unless you come to the personal form of the Absolute Truth, there is difficulty and there is chance of falling down. Sarva dharma alparitajya, mami tamta. This is the most confidential information. Gujyatam, sarva guhyatam. So, if you want to take the most confidential instruction of Krishna, then mami tamta sarva guhyatam. Then go on.
What is that? Because if they take Christianity as Krishna consciousness, what do you say?
Everything is Krishna consciousness. It is question of degrees. Mamo Panthang, what is that word? Bhaktante Manusha Partha Sarva. Everyone is chanting after Krishna. But they are forward to some step. Suppose Krishna is there on the top. And it is 100 steps. So somebody has covered 5 steps, somebody has covered 10 steps, somebody has covered 100 steps, like that. So everyone is setting up a Krishna. But there is degrees of realization of Krishna. So either Christian, Mohammedan or any sect, they are setting up a Krishna, that's all right. But it is a question of degrees, how far they have gone. The last stage is sarva dharma paritajya mam ekam. That is the final. No, it is Krishna consciousness is there in the Bhagavad Gita. It is not nobody's property. It is Krishna's minister. So, if you kindly advance in Krishna consciousness, then you will understand. What is that?
What is the name? No, that was meditation.
Meditation?
No, that was
Dhyanamasthitatadgatena manasa apashyanti yam yogina. This is meditation. By meditation I try to find out Krishna within your heart. Because Krishna is situated in everyone's heart. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddhese arjuna tishtha. So that is dhyan. Find out. In the shastra we understand Krishna is within my heart. And if you meditate, try to find out Krishna. Then, if you are fortunate, you will be able to see him. This is meditation.
Existed prior to
Dwapara Yuga. Here, it is always existing. Those who are expired, they are seeing him. Krishna is just like Brahma Samhita. He mentions Krishna. Ishara Parama Krishna. So many Dwapara Yugas before. Many millions of Dwapara Yugas before. Do you understand it? Brahma is the first teacher in the creation. Many millions of years ago, he uttered this word, Ishara Parama Krishna.
Krishna
is one. It is very popular here also. Otherwise, why you have come here? So, Krishna is popular in India very much. At every house, they observe Krishna Janmashtami. Unfortunately, you are forgetting. You are forgetting this. That is the misfortune. No. Regular life is Arjuna. Arjuna understood Bhagavad Gita. So before understanding Bhagavad Gita, he was a soldier. So after hearing Bhagavad Gita, he remained a soldier. He did not give up the battlefield. Now Krishna, I have understood, I have given up everything, I am now going to be sannyas. No. That is not required. You have to understand what Krishna wants you to do. That is Krishna. That you can do in any position. It doesn't require. Karma phalatya. That is advised by Krishna. See this. Krishna says, sarva dharman parityaja. We have manufactured different types of religious system. They can be grouped. Some of them are within the group of tyaga, and some of them are within the group of bhoga and tyaga. The kurmis, they are after bhoga, and jnanis, they are after tyaga. Krishna says that you have to give up both of them, this bhoga and tyaga. Both, you have simply to surrender it to me. There is no question of bhoga and tyaga. Does not say that you go everywhere. What they say, I do not know. I know what Krishna says. That's all. No, we are not concerned with others. We are putting our Krishna consciousness means our mission is to present before you what Krishna says. That's all. We are not concerned what others says. We are not. Yes, there is. In the sixth chapter, Mapparam. He has explained, Yoginamapi Sarvesam Madhvata Antarātmana Sadhyāvān Bhajati Jomam Samayajuktatamo. That is first class yogi, with all his thinking, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. He is first class. All right. Yes, get in now. Chant Hare Krishna, enjoy everything.